Hello TaleForgers! In this video we'll learn how to check if player is grounded in Unity ECS. We will use collision ward for collision detection and configure physics shapes. So let's see how to implement it. First of all, let's clean up the hierarchy, create new empty objects, level and systems. Of course, reorganize objects to desired parents. Go to the player prefab and select force unique in physics shape settings, because we want to make sure that there is only one instance of this particular collider. Let's modify the parameters. Center x equals minus 0.5 and y minus 0.1. Adjust scene window position a bit so I can see changes in the collider. Set size to, let's say, x equals 2.61, y 2.54. Bevel radius to 0.6. I think these parameters are fine for me. Friction mode to maximum. Also, in the physics body component, set inertia tensor on x and y to infinity to prevent incorrect player rotations after jump or landing. Most importantly, let's add two physics categories. Player, 0, and ground, 1. They are responsible for determining whenever is detection with desired layer or not. Player prefab belongs to player and collides with ground. Okay, let's go to ground prefab and add physics body. Set motion to static. Ground prefab belongs to ground and collides with player. Let's also add second ground instance and position it so we can test jumping later. Also position player to first platform or to second. I think it looks better in editor preview. Okay, let's write some code. Go to player movement component data and add a new field that will hold the grounded state. Public bool is grounded. Also, we need to add this field to player aspect with getter and setter, so we can modify state at the runtime. So move on to player movement system file, player movement job, execute method. Here we just want to add a condition check. If negation player aspect dot is grounded, return. Simple as that, because we want to block player movement during the jump. It's time to create player ground component data script, change to struct, and implement iComponentData. Then add public float free overlap detection offset. You want to detect collision with the ground, so we need to add offset to the player's center position. Of course, let's create the Authoring class. Add serialized field private float free overlap detection offset. And also a getter. Next, we need to create a player ground baker class, implement baker interface, and bake method. Then, let's get entity with transfer usage flags dot none. Add player ground component data to this entity and pass necessary parameter overlap detection offset. So now we want to implement player ground aspect. In this read only partial struct, we need to declare ref read write player ground component data field to get offset. Create a getter. Public float free, overlap detection offset, PlayerGroundComponentData.ValueReadOnly.OverlapDetectionOffset. That's it. Let's move on to implementing the PlayerGroundSystem. Let's create new struct, add partial keyword, and implement iSystem. Also create onCreate, onUpdate, and onDestroy methods. Don't forget about bearsCompile attributes. This time we need to register our system to update in fixed step simulation system group due to physics operations. Okay, let's add required for update components: player ground component data and physics word singleton. We want to get current collision word from this singleton. Now let's implement iSystem start stop interface. So we can add on start running and on stop running, which are equivalent of the on enable and on disable. Also add bearsCompile attributes and rearrange methods. On stop running should be empty. In onStartRunning, add getSingletonEntity, PlayerGroundComponentData, then getAspect, PlayerGroundAspect. Let's create new float-free variable, OverlapDetectionOffset, so we can read value in onStartRunning from PlayerAspect. It's time to implement onUpdate. Let's write collision word. Collision word equals system API dot get singleton physics word singleton dot collision word. Collision word implement overlap box method, which we want to handle in our code to detect if player is grounded. Next, create new partial struct player ground job. Remember to implement iJob entity and add execute method. As always, add bearsCompile attribute. In the execute method parameters, let's add player aspect in physics collider and in local transform. iJob entity creates a query that will retrieve the necessary parameters, and if entity with necessary parameters exists, then it will execute a job logic. We need to pass two parameters in order to implement ground check: read only collision word and also read only float free overlap detection offset. Okay, back to onUpdate method. Let's pass collision word and overlap detection offset. Then schedule job. Let's implement the job logic, create a new native list, distance heat, heats, with allocator.tempJob, because we need to store all heat collisions somewhere. Okay, so we write isGrounded equals collision word.overlapBox, pass playerTransfer.position plus overlapDetectionOffset, it is center position of our box, new quaternion 0001, so no rotation, and field parameter is half extents, which we don't have, same as last parameter, collision filter. So let's enable unsafe code, because we need to get pointer of the collider to get size and collision filter. Wait for Unity to apply changes, go to project settings, player, over settings, allow unsafe code. Now create a new variable boxCollider equals boxCollider asterisk physicsCollider.collider pointer. We cast collider pointer to the boxCollider pointer so we can read the box size. As you can see, I got an error, so I have to add unsafe keyword to execute method. also add the variable boxGeometry equals boxCollider arrow geometry. Because we are working with pointers, we need to use the arrow operator, not the dot operator. So back to our overlap box, pass boxGeometry.size divide by 2, because this parameter is half extent of the box. Next, pass a reference to hits, and as the last parameter, boxCollider arrow getCollisionFilter, because we want the layers to be checked exactly the same way as for the player. One last thing, let's set the isGrounded flag to the state returned by the OverlapBox function. We can also add for debug purposes, for each with Debug.DrawLine, from player position to hit position with magenta color, duration equals 10 seconds. At the end, remember to dispose hits. So go back to Unity, recompile. Let's create new empty object PlayerGround and attach a PlayerGroundAuthoring component. Set offset to, let's say, 0, -0.2, 0. Also, you can create an empty object, name it physics debug display, and attach a script with the same name. Check draw colliders, press play, and you can see colliders in game. It is a really great tool for debugging physics. Red color means dynamic rigid body motion, dynamic collider, while green means static rigid body, collider. You can even change state in runtime. Also, you can see magenta debug lines. Press spacebar multiply times to perform jump, and my system correctly detects if player is grounded, because I can't jump being in air. And that's what it is all about. I would like to invite you to support us on Patreon. Even a small contribution will help us to develop the channel and the quality of the content present. Also, I invite you to Discord and other social media. Links in the description. In the next video, we'll focus on the long-awaited topic, animations in Unity ECS. Thank you for your time. I'm glad you are with us and our community is growing. See you soon in the next video.